Yo, Adam Saxon with Kinda Cube, and in this video, we're going to explore permissions with apps, and there's some things you need to know about it. Stay tuned. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, on one of our live streams, we got a pre-submitted question from Adam. He's struggling with the app permissions, right? So the father's talking. You know, we like to do it here on Kinda Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine and look at it. So here's the scenario. I'm logged in as Joe Black, and you can see here that he's a pro user from the license type. Now, if I go into my apps, an app has been published to me, and in this app, there's a report that is live connected to a data set that's in a different workspace. So when I go to open that app, you'll see here that I get a message saying permission required. I can't see the content. What the French toast? Like what? Why? Like this should work. It works for my user because I had access to both. But when I publish it to someone else that doesn't have access to that data set, it doesn't work. And that is expected, right? So we don't necessarily want people to be able to access those data sets without the actual defined permission. All right, cool. So here's what Adam did. We'll go back to the original workspace. So build test one is where the data set is. So this is the data set that that other report is built on. So I'm just gonna update the app. Let me give Joe Black access to this. All right, we'll update that. Yeah, it says 5 to 10 minutes. It's actually pretty quick. We'll close that. Let's go back out. Let's go back to Joe. So Joe should have access now. So let's go back. We'll just refresh for good measure. And if we go back into apps and we go back to build test three, nothing. Now I'm confused, right? You're thinking to yourself, wait, I gave them permissions to the app, so they should have permission to the underlying data set. That's not actually how it works. And so while I was going through this, one thing which I think is actually what's tripping up a lot of people is this. Come back in. Joe has to actually install the app. You don't just get it by default. So I'm going to say get build test one. That's that other workspace. All right. This report works. Cool. And so now if I go back and I go to build test three, it works. Having installed that other app, now that gives Joe permission in the second app to actually utilize that data set. So now he can actually see the data set and he can get to that data set. And so I don't know the actual reason why it was designed this way. I believe it has to do with, do you actually have a line of sight to that data set? And without installing the app, it's not applying those permissions. The challenge here is that Joe, the user, is installing the build three app and doesn't necessarily know about the build one app. And so, you know, it's not the greatest of scenarios from Joe's perspective, right? So you have to educate Joe on what he has to go do because it's not going to install the required apps downstream. Maybe this will change in the future. I don't know, but that's how it's working right now. There is another option that you have in terms of actually getting this to work. So let me go and uninstall the app. So we'll delete build test one, and then we'll go back to my publisher. One thing I do want to call out here is if I go to build report one data set and go down to manage permissions, you'll notice that Joe Black is still listed here and he's listed because of the app. So he gets inherent permissions because of the app, but it didn't actually translate until you install the app. So if we go back, let me remove Joe Black from the app. Update that. And this is saying, look, you're removing things. Also, it says, look, when you update the app, it might take a little while. And users who already have permission to the underlying data set will retain their permissions. What does that mean? So if we go down to manage permissions, you'll see that Joe Black is still here, but now instead of app, it says read. Joe explicitly has read access on the data set. One thing you could have done was just add Joe Black here with explicit read permissions, and this would have worked. So to illustrate that, so now he doesn't have the app installed. And if we go back to build test three, it still works. Even though I don't have build test one installed, and you may be sitting there going like, no, Adam, it's just cached, right? It hasn't pulled that back. Let me show you. So if we go back, I'm gonna remove access altogether. If we go back to build test three, and now I'm back to the permission error. So it's not a caching thing, right? So the fact that just having read access on that data set will allow this to work without having to install the other app. So that's something you could do proactively. So if you have a security group of some, I recommend security groups. add the security group from a managed permission perspective, and then they'll just be able to get access to that data set. And just installing the Build Test 3 app will work. They don't have to install any other apps as part of that. One other thing I want to show here, let's go and add Joe back to the data set permissions. And I'm going to uncheck all of these. Specifically, I do not want build access. So Joe only has read access, which we had before, which we know worked. So now let's go back to Joe and we'll validate that this does work. We'll go to build test 3 and this works, which is what we expected. Let's talk about composite models. So a while back, there was a blog post that outlined an update to permissions needed when using composite models. So specifically, I'm going to refer to direct query with analysis services or Power BI datasets. What the blog post said is that if you are backed by premium per user or by premium, then all you need is read permission. It used to be that you needed build permission, but the blog post goes on to say that if you are a pro user, then it does still require build permission. As of right now, this is still a little bit in flux, so you may actually get a mixed experience. Some of you may find that all you need is read permission, and the rest of you may still require build permission. This is something the Power BI team is working on, so stay tuned up for more information. But let me show you this actually working. Now, I still only have read permission on the underlying data set, so in my case, this does work. So if I go here to build report 6, we can see that this is a composite model to build one data set and build workspace 1. So this is using the direct query over Power BI data sets, but Joe Black still only has read permission to the data set, does not have build permission. So again, try read permission. If it doesn't work, go back and put build permission on. It should take care of it and let it go further. So if you're in a premium per user workspace, obviously those users are going to need premium per user. If it's a premium capacity workspace, then everyone can get to it. Hopefully this clears up app permissions. I know it's a little confusing, but I wanted to set it straight based on what we showed in the live stream. Yes, this does work. All right, let me know in the comments if you have any other questions about permissions needed for app access and content. Happy to answer those. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.